On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. And I will cling to the old for a crown.
Good evening and welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. I greet you for the new year and I wish you all the best this year in Jesus' name. You are welcome to the program Help from Above. Prepared by the new painter Cessus and presented to you by Brother Vin Baba. Let's bow our hearts to prayer. Father, we thank you for today. Thank you for the privilege to draw near to you to hear your words. We have come to you. We ask that you will speak to us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now, our basic text has been 1 Corinthians 1, verse 18. And our theme had been the power of the cross. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 18 says the message of the cross, to those that perish it is foolishness, but to those who are being saved it is the power of God. The message of the cross is the power of God. And we have been talking about the cross of Christ, the cross on which Jesus died. He suffered so much and died there for us. And we said God has seen the fall of man right even before man fell. And he has prepared that he was going to rescue man from the effect of the fall by sending Jesus to die on the cross. And right from that beginning, we have discovered that each time God had come to solve the problem of man on earth, the way he will solve it will be pointing to the cross. As if saying that it is the cross of Christ that he was going to use ultimately to deliver man from sin and from the devil. And the last time we looked at the children of Israel when they were in bondage in the land of Egypt, they were there 430 years, and it came to a point that they began to plead with Pharaoh that he should allow them to go, that they want to go and serve the Lord their God. Well, we thought that he would say, Kai, you have stayed for too long. You can be going now. He will not let them go. They cried, he will not let them go. In fact, he said that they should trouble them the more. So that they will forget about this, their cry to go away from Egypt. They said, let us go. He said, no, I will not let you go. And we said that is how Satan is. He will not allow those who have come under his bondage to go. Even if you cry, he will not let you go. Even if you cut yourself, he will not let you go. Even if you try to struggle by your power, he will not let you go. And that is the way in which it is with us. In our bondage to sin and to the devil, he will not let us go. Even if we cry, he will not let us go. Moses said to Pharaoh, let my people go. He performed a lot of miracles that brought a lot of suffering to the people of Egypt, including the house of Pharaoh himself. But he will not let them go. His heart was hardened. And I want to say to us that the heart of Satan is actually hardened. He will not let any man go. No matter for how long we live under his bondage. Moses performed a lot of miracles that touched the heart, very heart of the people. But Pharaoh will not let him go. But the Lord said to him, there is one more thing I will do in the land of Egypt. Pharaoh will let you go. He will let you go. And what he asked them to do at that time is also another thing that is like pointing to the cross. It's a shadow of the cross. And when they had got that thing done, Pharaoh rushed them to go. His power was broken. He let them go. And what was it? The Lord said to Moses, tell the people that on the 10th day of this month, every man or every household should take a lamb. A lamb without blemish. A male of the first year. That is just maturing. Select him from the herd and tie it somewhere for 4 days. On the fourth day, at twilight, kill it and put the blood On the doorpost.
Et là on met bas et par commission jour.
And on top of the lintel.
To ni me guazun ya ya commission.
And he said to them.
He said,
"This night, when you have done it, my angel of destruction will pass through the land.
Malaika nyegbigbi won adazan za ni mi kinana.
And any house that does not have the sign of that blood."
Their
firstborn will die.
The
firstborn of their flocks will die. And it was. The people of God, they obeyed. Now the story I'm telling you is from Exodus chapter 12. From verse 1 to verse 13. Now hear what the word of the Lord said. He said, "Now the blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. When I see the blood, I will know that I have a covenant of mercy with you. When I see the blood, I will remember that I have entered into a covenant of protection with you. When I see the blood, I will not allow the angel of destruction to enter your house. I will not allow the evil to enter into your house. When I see the blood," and he also said, "with this, I'm going to judge the gods of Egypt. I'm going to break the powers of the gods of Egypt. I'm going to break the power of Pharaoh over your life." This is symbolic of the cross. This is the shadow of the cross. And God also said to them, "From this time that you keep these words, I'm going to give you a new beginning. This will be to you the beginning of months. And from this point that you begin to experience a new thing, I will walk with you and carry you to the land of promise." Now, as we have said, this is symbolic of the cross. This is the shadow of the cross. This is like what Jesus did for us on the cross. Right from the time that he came and began to preach, the way they described him, they described him as a lamp of God. As the lamp of God. And when he was going to the cross, he was the lamp of God, like without blemish. He had lived by that time for almost 33 years of age. Yet without sin. He was the lamp of God. Meek and lowly. Holy without blemish. Just like the one that God asked them to take in the land of Egypt at that time. He entered into Jerusalem almost about 4 days to the time that he was killed.
Jerusalem
And And he was killed about the same time that they normally kill the Passover lamb. But our story, the importance has to do with the issue of the blood. As the blood of the lamb was placed on the doorpost at that time,
Kendo na ala egayan nangi na jazun kimbagba na aban bamisun ya kumisun fogana.
The most important thing was the blood.
And ipataki bago na yegya.
And for the cross,
ya ebuma.
The most important thing about the dying of Christ is the blood.
And pataki eti tutu ya Jesu bago unyi egya.
The blood that he shed.
Egya na ujeyana.
Yes, man has sinned. And the result of that sin is death. But when we believe in Christ and believe what he did for us on the cross, as blood of the Lamb stood for them at that time, his blood will stand for us today. As the blood of the Lamb saved them from the wrath of God, even so, today, the blood of Jesus saves us from the wrath of God.
For
God said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. When I see the blood, I will not allow the destructive angel to come into your house. The blood of Jesus saves us from the wrath of God concerning our sins. The blood of Jesus brings us into the covenant of mercy with God. The blood of Jesus bring us into a covenant of protection with God. When the angel of destruction is passing, God will say, no, you cannot touch these people, they are my people. You must not bring death to these people, they are my people. And I want to also say, the blood of Jesus secures us from the powers of hell. The blood of Jesus saves us from the powers of darkness. When the blood is seen, they cannot come near us. There is nothing they can do to the man who has his life under the cover of the blood. Their powers are useless under the cover of the blood. Friend, this is what Jesus did for us on the cross of Calvary. And if a man comes to him and sincerely believes and turns his back from sin and asks Jesus to come into his heart, this blood will save us from wrath. This blood will bring us into a new covenant with the Lord our
God.
The covenant of care and protection. The covenant of mercy will be on us every day of our lives. It will be a new beginning. It will be a new thing that the Lord will begin to do to move us into what he has planned out for us. And it is true. All those that ever came to Jesus, believing in what he did on the cross of Calvary, they experience a new beginning. The person that has been struggling with sin experiences deliverance and enters into a new beginning. The person that is a drunkard gets the power of drunkenness broken from his life and enters into a new beginning. There are several testimonies of these. This is not theory at all. Those that have been under the powers of darkness, when they believe on what Christ did for them on the cross, the powers of those demons get broken and they experience a new beginning. Those that have been under the spell of wickedness and a curse, when they believe on the cross of Christ and what he did for them there, they receive deliverance and they enter into a new beginning. A beginning of joy, victory. A beginning that helps them in their new walk with God. Oh, the blood of the cross of Calvary.
Ah, egiyan Jesu Christ yan Calvary.
If the blood of the Lamb gave them deliverance, if the blood of the Lamb at that time brought them such deliverance, how much more the blood of Jesus, the precious blood of Jesus. Oh, he did so much for us. That blood means so much to us. That blood had accomplish in us much more than the blood of that Lamb accomplished in the land of Egypt. Will you believe today? Do you desire a deliverance from the power of sin and the power of Satan? Do you desire a new beginning of victory and joy and peace? Do you desire a new beginning that will put you into a covenant relationship with God? The covenant of mercy and grace. Then you must pray this prayer with me now. You must yield your heart to Christ now. And you can pray where you are. I will guide you to pray. And something will happen in your life. It will be a new beginning. I'd like you to bow your heart where you are. And pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I'm sorry for the way I've lived. I'm sorry for the way I've lived. I believe you died on the cross for me. You shed your blood on the cross for me. Oh, use that blood and cleanse me. Let that blood bring me deliverance. Let that blood break the power of sin and the devil over my life. Give me a new beginning. Jesus, come into my heart. Come and make me a new person. Come and give me a new heart. Thank you because you have done it. In Jesus' name we pray. Now we want to help you further. If you have prayed this prayer with us, we would like to help you further. Or you have questions you want to ask, you can call us. Or you want to give your heart to Christ, and you want further understanding and help, you can call us on these numbers. By the grace of God, same time on Saturday, 5 to 5:30, we will bring you the word of God.
Asibina ebena ya keje laigan sokona bia ebe be figutun lo efinigutun be gan fi yen lo zun.
God bless you.
Sokuje patal barika.
And have a great year.
Ichi denima eana.
Thanks for listening.
Ekunbe tupashi.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To that old rugged cross I